Vizio V-Series 5.1 channel soundbar system with wireless subwoofer. Setup. First, let's hook up the subwoofer to the rear surround speakers. I'll show you this on the table so it's easy to see. You simply connect the appropriate color-coded speaker cable to the back of each satellite speaker. Then you connect the other end of the cable to the back of the subwoofer. Those ports are also color-coded, so you don't get the left and right connections mixed up. Then you plug the shorter power cable into the back of the subwoofer's power port. And of course, plug the other end into an electrical outlet. I'll place the subwoofer next to the side of my couch in the back of my room. I'll place the satellite speakers on my end tables next to my couch, one on the left side, one on the right side. Now let's hook up the soundbar. It has several connections. Let's go over each one. You will use the connections that are appropriate for your TV and your additional equipment. After I go through them, you'll know what to do. On the back of the soundbar, there's a power port where you connect the longer power cable. Of course, plug the other end into an electrical outlet. There's also a USB port. You could connect a USB drive to it, for example, and if it has WAV music files on it, you could then play those files through the system. On the other side of the back of the soundbar, we have more inputs. If your TV has a HDMI ARC connection, then you'll want to use the HDMI cable supplied to connect your TV to the soundbar. HDMI ARC is the best connection type if it's available. The next best option is using the digital optical port. If your TV has this connection, simply use the supplied digital optical cable and connect it to your soundbar and then to your TV. If you have an older TV or device, you may only have RCA connections available. No problem, just use the 3.5mm to RCA cable. Plug the 3.5mm side into the top right 3.5mm port on the soundbar and the RCA side to the TV. You can also use this aux port to connect a device with a 3.5mm output. Just use the 3.5mm to 3.5mm cable. Connect one end into the device, in this case an old cassette player. Plug the other end into the top right 3.5mm port on the soundbar. You'll notice another 3.5mm port below the 3.5mm aux port that we've been discussing. This second port is known as aux VA. The VA stands for Voice Assistant. You can use the included 3.5mm to 3.5mm cable to connect to a device with Amazon Alexa, Google Assistant, or Siri. Then you will be able to hear the assistant's voice on the Vizio speaker system. Great for playing back music from these devices as well. The system also has Bluetooth pairing. For example, if I press and hold the Bluetooth button on the top of the soundbar for 5 seconds, I can launch the Settings app on my iPhone, go to Bluetooth, make sure that Bluetooth is on, and then select Vizio V51. Now, if I close Settings and launch a music app, I can play music on my phone, and the sound will play through the Vizio speakers. That's pretty much it for system setup. I was able to hear surround sound through the system, playing through my TV after doing these initial setup steps. It was pretty easy. If you're having any issues at this point, it's probably because you need to go into your TV or device's menu and change some settings. Each device is different. See your device's user manual. Proper speaker placement. For the best surround experience, position the soundbar in front of your TV at ear level. The right and left surround speakers go behind where you sit, on the right and left sides respectively. They should also be at an ear level height if possible. The subwoofer can sit on the floor. Since it's connected to the surround speakers, you can place it near those speakers. The important thing is to not block the subwoofer's port. If you don't have room to put the surround speakers in the back of the room, you can place them on the sides of the soundbar as shown, with the subwoofer nearby on the floor. But this is not the preferred setup. But don't sweat it if you don't have a choice. This setup will still sound much, much better than your TV's speakers alone. Well, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe.